Hello everybody and welcome back to the show. I hope you all had a lovely couple of weeks. I think I haven't done a video for 2 weeks now, because that's due to like work and family, and it was my little one's birthday, so we had stuff to prepare for that. But you didn't come here for that information, so I'm just going to say thank you for bearing with me. And because we've got no new information per se, I thought I'd try something a bit different, and we'll have a little bit of a discussion topic. So on with tonight's video. Right then guys, it's time to get down to the brass tacks of the video. So as we know, there's been a new release for AOS, and it's called Forbidden Power, which is opening up more magic and stronger spells and whole new scenery for AOS. And we've seen the build up to this with Malign Potency and you know, the Soul War saga that we're currently undergoing. But this year alone, we have seen quite a lot of battle tomes already, and they've been fabulous. I gotta be honest, I know I've ridiculed GW for re-releasing a Blades of Khorne one when it wasn't long done, and they were fine. But it is phenomenal. I gotta say it is phenomenal. But I wanna talk about what factions do we want to see next. What factions do you guys think will be coming up in, say, the next couple of months? Are we going to see, I don't know, another 4 battle tomes over the next couple of months, or is it just going to slow down because we got Warcry coming up, we've got all new 40k stuff coming as well, I think, with their ongoing Vigilus campaigns and this, that, the other. And also Halflings being released for Blood Bowl, absolutely phenomenal. And we got Wood Elves to worry about as well, but we're not here for that, we're here for AOS. So I've got a little bit of a prediction, I want to say, and it's going to be a complete farce because it's all going to be wrong. It's just, you know, it's just what I would like to see. And if you agree with me, let me know. If you don't agree with me, let me know again. Tell me why I'm wrong and tell me why it's never going to happen. And yeah, I want to know your opinions on this, guys. So we're going to start off with the most, well, least likely, and then to the ones that I want to see very, very much. So let's get into it. Right then guys, before I begin, I'm just going to say, I know Sylvaneth are coming out, because as you know from my previous videos, we have covered the fact that it's on the back burner a minute because they've had a bit of problems with the production line. I think it's to do with battle tomes and shipping and what have you not. But we know that's coming, so I've not added it to the list, but we know it's coming, so it's not going to be part of the guessing. So before anybody puts that down in the comments. But anyway, completely sidetracked, let's get back on track. First up, I want to see something else added to the Destruction faction, and that would be Gutbusters as an army. We've got the Beast Claw Raiders, and they've got it's a nice bit of fluff. And I shouldn't say fluff, that's going to offend people. That's a nice bit of lore, where they continually marching in front of a mystical blizzard, and they're going to try and keep on the go all the time. But we need a little bit extra, because we know we've got like fire bellies, man eaters, and whatnot. But what are they doing? So I'd like to see a proper Gutbusters army, because who doesn't like augurs with big massive shields covering their belly buttons? I think it would be fantastic, and it's probably going to be quite a few people willing to dust off their previous collections and are not interested in playing Beast Claw Raider. So, you know, it's a win-win, I would see that as. Right then, next up on the list, guys, is everyone's favourite nutcases. It's the Iron Jaws. I think these guys could do with, you know, their own Ender spells. I know they cost some Immaline potency, which seems more to do with them, like the Nashian Maws. But I'd like to see some Iron Jaws specific spells. And I think they could do with a bit of a boost, because I know these are always going to be pushed by GW as the easiest faction to like get a hold of, because it's a few models, and they're very forgiving, because they got, you know, good movement, they got a good strength, good saves. But from the people I know that have played them, they're quite a technical army. There's nuance to them to get the best out of them, so perhaps something to, you know, if they're going to aim this army at newcomers, but there's nuance to it, perhaps we need something to like iron out a few creases. So that's why I would like to see this redone, because it's a fantastic army, and we know, like, you know, they've got an amazing lore, and these are going to be like everyone's favourite. Everyone is an Orc fan, and Iron Jaws are the best of the best. They are Gork's right hand, and Mork's right hand, and everyone else's foot. But they're fantastic. I think these are fabulous models, the ones that they have released. I'm not expecting new models if they did release it, but it would be nice to see what they're doing now with the Necroquake being done, and having their own spells, you know, like we could have the big massive foot, we could have Gnashing Maws, and I think that would be phenomenal, because, like, you know, it's very orky then, isn't it? So, oh, yeah, that's something, I would be eager to see that. What do you guys think? Right then, guys, we've got another, you know, re-release, if I get my way, and that's going to be the Seraphon Army, because I feel they kind of were a bit meh when they came out. There was nothing spectacular with them, and the lore seemed a little bit, I don't know, well, to me it was a bit naff. It just feels like it was very poorly executed. It felt rushed. It just felt like they didn't care, they just wanted to get the models out there, because it's something like the Order Demons, or they're a Dream Lizard, or something really weird. And if you want to explain a faction as, are they a bunch of dream wizards remembered by a fat toad, doesn't really go, ooh, that's an army I want to collect. So perhaps we need a little bit more meat on the bones when it comes to that, because it seems a bit weird that they're out in space and then they come down, fight a load of chaos, then disappear and never really die. It just seems like it's a muddle of everything. I would have probably been more impressed, like, if, I don't know, Nagash was Krokgar's father, and, you know, he was a big, you know, adventure in space and everything like that. Perhaps that's in the next expansion, but it seems a little bit naff. So that's the lore side of it. The rules wise could do with a bit of tidying up, because I know there are quite a few players that you know, feel a little bit underwhelming. And again, if you've got these all powerful magical slan, wouldn't you want to see, like, what ender spells they could put on the field, and, you know, what they could do? That would be amazing. There you go, guys. And last but not least, to this very short video, I want to see what Malarian's faction are going to bring to, you know, the AOS realms. because we know nothing about the Malarian side of things. We know Marathi is she's got all these twisted souls, and she's kind of taken a bit more than what she needs, so that's why the Hedonites are on it, you know, on the tail of them and Malarian and Ulgo. We know Teclis created the Idenev and he disavowed them and they hate them. We know that Elariel is there with her dryad and her trees and her massive bug having fun, all hippy dippy, you know, flower power and all that jazz. But we know nothing about these guys. We know diddly squat. All we know is they are based in Ulgo, the realm of Shadow, which is a perfect setting when you would think of Malarian. And then on top of that, we've only got this one image that they've put in a book, and it just screams power, shadowy figure. I want to see what they can do for his army, whether it's going to be, you know, a massive model of Malarian, or is he going to be like Marathi, where he has two forms? Is he like part dragon now? Is it, are his units freaking the same as what they were? Are they completely different? Are they changed? Have they got special like stealth rules? There's something mysterious about this that makes people want to see this army, and I think this is, you know, this is the epitome of keeping a very good secret and just making people yearn for the end result. And I hope to high heaven when they do drop the Malarian bomb, it's worth it. It's not Seraphon big bag of meh. It's going to be fantastic. It's going to be a realm shaker. So do you guys agree? Do you want to see the Malarian faction? Do you think we got too many elves as it is and we need, I know, more humans, say, like free people? Do we want to see more Dwarven factions? Do we want to see like the free people's version of the tribes, like they're doing with the tribes in Warcry for Chaos? What do you guys think? Am I completely wrong? Would you not want to see anything here? Am I just wishlisting and I'm out on my own? Let me know. And yeah, we could, perhaps we could do another one where you guys have voted for what you want to see. And yeah, that's the end of the video, guys. And that is it, listeners. That's the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed the video. I really do, because without you guys, there is no show. So if you enjoyed the video, please press the like button. If you didn't like it, press the dislike. But you know, if you press it, please tell us what you think, like where we gone wrong. Tell us if you think we're right, because all your comments would improve the show. If you're not yet a subscriber, please subscribe so you don't miss out on future content. I'm not going to ask you to ring the bell, because it's me at the end of the day. You listen to me when you want to. As long as you subscribe, that was more than enough. And I would like to thank everyone that has listened to this video from the bottom of my heart before I carry on, because next up I've got a little bit of shilling, which is we've got Noobway on Teesprings. I can't link it to the account just yet because they tell me I've got to have like 1,000 subscribers and yada yada yada. But if you want to Teesprings, type in Noob with Brush. You see the store for us, so get on there and get your Noob gear on. We've also got a PayPal account, which is in the link down below. But if you just want to watch a video, just that's more than enough for us. Thank you very much, and I shall see you in the next video. Hopefully I'll have, you know, a longer video, and you know, we can carry on this discussion.